Hey, it's Sergi, and welcome to the Safety Fellowship Podcast. For safety talks, safety blogs, safety articles, safety learning and awareness, and all other safety subject matters, log on to safefellow.com. Come on, let's talk safety. Hey, welcome. And today's topic is keeping safe with hazardous material. Hazardous materials severely affect human health. It is one of the primary reasons for many serious diseases, including cancer. Creating a safety culture to protect oneself and the community is essential. All hands should learn methods of handling and transporting hazardous materials. Proper handling of hazardous material is paramount to living a healthy lifestyle. The primary purpose of this podcast today is to inform about hazardous material, how it affects human health, and the safety precautions when dealing with hazardous materials. So, what is hazardous material? Hazardous material can be defined as a chemical or substance classified as a physical hazard material or a health hazard material. Either the chemical or substance is in usable or waste condition. And this definition is according to the NFPA 400. I'll repeat the definition again. Hazardous material can be defined as a chemical or substance classified as a physical hazard material or a health hazard material. Either the chemical or substance is in usable or waste condition. In simplicity, hazardous material is any substance that can harm human health and the living environment, and such materials are referred to as dangerous goods, and proper handling is required to avoid disaster. Types of hazardous materials. There are 9 classifications of hazardous material. Class 1 includes explosives, that is fireworks, dynamite. And class 2 for hazardous materials include gases. An example are acetylene or lighter. And the class 3 includes, the class 3 are the flammable liquids, which includes gasoline or alcohol. And the class 4 are the flammable solids, which includes oily rags, matches, or dirty rags. And the class 5 are the oxidizers, or the organic peroxides. Examples are potassium peroxides. And the class 6 of hazardous materials are the toxic and infectious substances. And examples include lead compounds. And the class 7 for hazardous materials are the radioactive material. And examples include iodine, uranium, or cobalt. And the class 8 for hazardous materials are the corrosives. And these include mineral acid, ammonia. And the class 9 are called miscellaneous. These could include motor vehicle battery, asbestos. So, what are the effects of these dangerous goods? What are the effects of hazardous material? On human, it could cause, like I said earlier on, cancer, kidney failure, physical deformation. And on to the environment, this could include the death of animals, including humans. It can cause mutation in animals. It reduces the lifespan of plants and the death of aquatic animals, that is animals in the water. Now let's talk about handling hazardous material. What rules should everyone follow to protect themselves from these dangerous goods? We should encourage each and everyone to follow chemical handling safety tips. And the number one safety tips is recognition. Firstly, it is essential to understand and recognize the hazardous material that is about to be in use. Read the instructive label, that is the material safety sheet that comes with the hazardous material, before using. Also, go through precautions to know how to handle them safely. The other tip is pre-planning. Consider having severe condition and make a pre-plan about handling an accident if it happens. Have a ready-to-go eye watch station or shower. The other safety tip is using PPE, that is personal protective equipment. Use new and clean personal protective equipment. Dispose old and damaged PPE. And the next safety tip is to mark all hazardous material correctly. Ensure all containers containing toxic chemicals label properly. And other safety tip is to use hazardous material only when needed. And the other one is to store the chemicals properly. Store hazardous materials and substances according to compatibility. Ensure container lids are closed tightly. Keep the storage area clean and don't overpack substances. Leave a breathing space between storage. And the next safety tip is disposal of waste hazardous material. The correct way of disposing used hazardous material are labeled or are mentioned in the material safety sheet. Follow these procedures properly. And the next safety tip is cleaning yourself after every use of hazardous material. Wash hands properly. If in need, take a shower. Hazardous materials are closer to us than we think. It is in our everyday living. Examples of these hazardous materials we come in contact every day are like our kitchen cleaners, our bathroom cleaners, your motor vehicle battery. All these are hazardous materials. So the general safety rules is what I gave earlier on. Always stay alert, wear the proper clothing while handling hazardous materials, that is your PPE. Keep storage areas clean. And my final thought on this hazardous material is a cleaner environment is essential for us to have a good, healthy living lifestyle. Don't throw waste material openly in the air. It can cause pollution that's gonna affect our health and our environment. Thank you for listening. And if you're in need of any other safety tips, log on to safefellow.com and read our blogs. Like, share, and please subscribe. Thank you once again. Bye. For safety talks, safety blogs, safety articles, safety learning and awareness, and all other safety subject matters, log on to safefellow.com. Come on, let's talk safety.